ever try to swat away a fruit fly and wonder, like, seriously, what is the point of this thing?
Right.
Get ready to have your mind blown, because today's deep dive is all about how those tiny pests are actually making huge waves in brain science.
Huge.
We're talking unlocking the secrets of sleep.
Sleep.
Memory.
Yeah.
Even devastating diseases like Alzheimer's.
That's true.
All thanks to those little buzzers hovering around your bananas.
It is funny how the most annoying creatures can sometimes hold the key to, like, groundbreaking discoveries.
Right.
What's truly fascinating is that fruit flies share a surprising amount of DNA with humans, about 60%.
Wow.
And that genetic similarity extends to their brains, making them incredible models for studying how our own minds work.
Okay, so they share some DNA, but do their brains really function like ours?
You'd be surprised. For example, fruit flies actually experience jet lag, just like we do.
Really?
Their internal clocks are thrown off when their sleep cycles are disrupted.
Mm-hmm.
And believe it or not, they can even get a little tipsy.
Wait, hold on.
Yeah.
Fruit flies get jet lag.
They do.
And drunk.
Yeah.
Seriously.
It's true. They're naturally drawn to fermenting fruit, and too much exposure to the alcohol produced during fermentation can actually intoxicate them. It's these surprising similarities to humans that make fruit flies such valuable subjects for researchers.
That's both hilarious and mind-boggling.
I know, right?
So we're talking about studying human-like brain functions, but in a creature, we can study throughout its entire lifespan in a fraction of the time.
Right.
It's like hitting fast forward on the most complex research.
Precisely. And that's where the really groundbreaking stuff comes in. Because of their short lifespans, studying things like neurodegenerative diseases, which can take decades to develop in humans, becomes much faster and more efficient in fruit flies. This has opened up incredible avenues for understanding diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's.
This is all blowing my mind already, and we haven't even gotten to the really cool part yet, right? I've heard whispers about scientists creating an actual map of a fruit fly's brain.
You're talking about the Flywire Project.
Uh-huh.
It's absolutely revolutionary. Imagine a 3D map of a fruit fly's brain with every single neuron and connection meticulously charted.
So they've literally created a wiring diagram for an entire brain.
They have.
How is that even possible?
It's an incredible feat of technology and collaboration. They're using advanced AI to analyze millions of images of a fruit fly's brain. But here's the really cool part. They've also enlisted the help of gamers.
Gamers. I am so lost right now. How do gamers fit into all of this?
It turns out that gamers are incredibly good at spotting patterns and making quick, accurate decisions, skills that are incredibly valuable when you're trying to trace the intricate pathways of neurons in a microscopic image.
So we've got scientists, cutting-edge AI, A&D gamers, all coming together to map the brain of a fly. This has to be one of the most unique research collaborations I've ever heard of.
It really speaks to the power of interdisciplinary collaboration in science. And the best part is, they didn't just keep all this data to themselves. They created something called the Flywire Codex.
The Flywire Codex. What is that? Some kind of ancient scroll containing the secrets of the fly brain?
It's actually even better than that. Think of it as Google Maps, but for a fruit fly's brain.
Okay, I need a little help wrapping my head around this. So the Flywire Codex is basically an open source, searchable map of a fruit fly's brain.
It is.
Created by scientists, AI, and gamers.
You got it. Anyone can zoom in and explore the neurons and connections in incredible detail. It's a game changer for researchers studying everything from basic brain function to complex neurological disorders.
It's like having a roadmap to the brain, and anyone with a computer can hop in the driver's seat and start exploring. This has to be accelerating research at an insane pace.
Absolutely. For example, remember how we were talking about fruit flies experiencing jet lag? Well, using the Flywire Codex, researchers can now actually trace the neural circuits involved in their sleep-wake cycles. They've identified specific genes that regulate these cycles, and the truly amazing thing is that many of these genes have counterparts in humans.
Wait, so by studying how a fly gets over jet lag, we could potentially develop new treatments for human sleep disorders. That's incredible.
It's one of the many possibilities. And it's not just sleep flies. Fruit flies have proven incredibly valuable in memory research as well.
You're gonna have to explain this one to me. How do you even test memory in a fly?
It's actually quite ingenious. Researchers can train fruit flies to associate certain smells with either a positive or negative experience, kind of like Pavlov's dogs.
So you're telling me we can teach flies? I'm officially out of my depth here.
It's true. And by studying the neural pathways activated during these learning and memory tasks in flies, researchers are gaining valuable insights into how human memory works, and more importantly, how memory-related disorders develop.
So from sleep to memory, these little flies are basically giving us a crash course in how the human brain works. It's like they're nature's little shortcut to unlocking some of the biggest mysteries in neuroscience.
Precisely. And we haven't even touched on one of the most promising areas of research yet, neurodegenerative diseases.
Oh, right. You mentioned that earlier, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, these are some of the most devastating and poorly understood diseases out there. How are fruit flies helping us tackle those challenges?
Remember how we talked about fruit flies having a short lifespan? That's particularly important in this case. Researchers can study the progression of neurodegenerative diseases much faster in flies than in humans.
So it's like hitting the fast forward button on disease research. Instead of waiting decades to observe disease progression, you can see the effects in a matter of weeks or months in flies. That's brilliant.
Exactly. And by manipulating the genes of fruit flies, scientists can create models that mimic certain aspects of human neurodegenerative diseases, like Alzheimer's. This allows them to test potential treatments and observe the effects in a much shorter time frame.
Okay, I have to ask. What does studying Alzheimer's in a fly actually look like? Do they, like, forget where they put their tiny fly car keys?
Well, not quite. But we can observe changes in their behavior and brain structure that are similar to what we see in humans with Alzheimer's. For example, researchers have identified a specific protein that accumulates abnormally in the brains of Alzheimer's patients, and they found that the same protein also accumulates in the brains of fruit fly models of the disease.
So by studying this protein in flies, researchers might be able to develop drugs that prevent its accumulation or even clear it out of the brain, potentially slowing down or even stopping the progression of Alzheimer's in humans. That's incredible.
It's a really exciting area of research, and the Flywire Codex is playing a key role in accelerating progress. By having a detailed map of the fly brain, researchers can pinpoint exactly which neurons and circuits are affected by the disease and target their treatments with much greater precision.
I'm starting to see why scientists are so excited about fruit fly research. These tiny creatures are like little windows into the complexities of the human brain, and they're helping us tackle some of the biggest challenges in neuroscience. But it's more than just the speed of research, right? It's also about the ethical considerations.
Absolutely. Studying these diseases in humans can be incredibly challenging, both logistically and ethically. With fruit flies, we can conduct research that would be much more difficult or even impossible to do in humans.
It's like they're the unsung heroes of brain research, quietly buzzing around in labs around the world, helping us understand our own brains and develop new treatments for some of the most devastating diseases we face. Who knew something so small could have such a huge impact?
And the most exciting part is that we've only scratched the surface. The Flywire Project and the Codex are still relatively new, and researchers are just beginning to explore their full potential.
So what does the future hold for fruit fly brain research? What are some of the big questions scientists are hoping to answer next? So we've talked about how fruit flies are helping us understand sleep memory, even neurodegenerative diseases. What's next? What are the big mysteries that scientists are hoping these little guys will help us solve?
The possibilities are truly mind-blowing.
Yeah.
One area of intense focus is understanding the neural basis of consciousness.
Hold on, consciousness. We're talking about figuring out what makes us aware, what makes us us, by studying flies. That seems like a pretty giant leap.
It might seem that way, but remember, at its core, consciousness is about information processing. Fruit flies, despite their tiny brains, display surprisingly complex behaviors in decision-making processes. By studying these processes at the neural level, researchers are hoping to glean insights into the fundamental principles of how brains, including ours, generate subjective experience.
So instead of asking, what is it like to be a fly, scientists are asking, what can a fly's brain teach us about how any brain creates the experience of being? That's a fascinating approach.
Exactly. And here's another exciting frontier. Brain-computer interfaces.
You mean like something out of a science fiction movie, controlling things with our minds?
It's not as far-fetched as it sounds. Researchers are already using fruit flies to develop and test early prototypes of these interfaces. Imagine being able to control a prosthetic limb, or even communicate directly with a computer just by thinking fruit flies could help make that a reality.
Okay, now my mind is officially blown. From unlocking the secrets of consciousness to developing mind-controlled technology, it seems like there's no limit to what we can learn from these tiny creatures.
It really underscores the importance of basic research and scientific curiosity. Sometimes the most groundbreaking discoveries come from the most unexpected places. Who would have thought that the annoying little flies buzzing around our food bowls could hold the key to unlocking some of the biggest mysteries of the human brain?
It's a great reminder that we should never underestimate the power of a tiny fly. while I, for one, am completely captivated by the world of fruit fly brain research. It's incredible how much we can learn from such a small creature.
It's a testament to the ingenuity of scientists and the endless wonders of the natural world. Who knows what other mysteries will unravel in the years to come?
If a tiny fly can hold the key to unlocking some of the brain's biggest secrets, imagine the possibilities that await us in the vast and intricate tapestry of life. That's why we do these deep dives. You just never know what's going to blow your mind next. Until next time, keep exploring the world around you with a sense of wonder. You never know what groundbreaking discoveries might be buzzing right under your nose.